Hi, in this video we're going to explore the Wonder Workshop app called Blockly. To locate the Blockly app, place your finger in the center of the iPad screen and swipe down and type Blockly and then tap on the Blockly app. You'll notice in the center of the screen there is a play button. Press play. Once this is open, there'll be a pop-up which talks about managing profiles. This is with an app called Classroom Connect. We don't need to use the Classroom Connect, but we can use the profiles. This is a brilliant way for students to be able to save their work on a particular iPad and come back to it later under a profile. So I'm going to skip connecting to the Classroom app, and it brings up a pop-up screen with three possible choices for coding in the Blockly app. One is with puzzles, one is with my projects, and the other is with create new. But first, we need to connect via Bluetooth a dash to the app. So, like all Wonder Workshop apps, we click on the plus icon in the top right-hand corner. Once we've clicked on the plus icon, I can see that there is a dash here with a red background, and I know the dash I'm connecting to has the name Ada on it, but it also has the red ears and chest LEDs. So I'm going to click on this to connect to Ada. Now I'm connected. I can tap back on the screen and I have my three different ways to code. In the top right-hand corner, you can see that I'm connected to Ada with the red background. Let's explore puzzles. Tap on puzzles. I'm working with dash, tap on dash. Puzzles comes with 13 projects for students to complete. These are fantastic because they gradually increase the skills that students use when coding with dash in Blockly. So let's have a look at how the puzzles works. And the tutorials are set up in the puzzles. I'm going to tap on the first puzzle, which is a stoplight. You get a scenario or a story to read through, and here we can see that Dash needs our help. We're going to teach Dash to drive safely around the Wonder Workshop neighbourhood square, which is full of surprises. Down in the bottom centre of the pop-up, we can see a blue arrow to move on to the next set of instructions. The instructions appear at the bottom of the screen. We can see a picture showing us what it's liking us to do in this part of the instruction. The written instruction at the bottom says press the start button at the bottom left of your screen to get Dash's engine going. And we can see in the illustration there is a finger pointing to the green and white start button. In the pop-up of the instruction, where the blue arrow is pointing down, we're going to press on that to close the illustration, and I'm going to press play in the left-hand corner. So it's completed the code and we get a little confirmation and a message saying good job. To move forward and get another instruction in this challenge, we press the green arrow. You can see that the next instruction says connect the blocks to teach Dash how to drive forward and press start to run your program. So I press on my blue down arrow to close the illustration, and I can see I have a when start block, which I can move around my space for coding, and I also have a forward. If the blocks are left like this and they're not connected, the code won't run. So we need to connect, move forward under when start is pressed. And then it said press start to run your program. So we press start and Dash then moves forward. And again, it says good job. Each tutorial within each challenge is like this. And we move through, we look at the illustration, we read the instruction, close the illustration and try to complete the task. If, for example, you complete the task and it's incorrect, it will let you know. So let's see what happens when something is incorrect. Here it's telling me that Dash is going to learn how to drive backwards. So I'll close this and I have a when start block. When I press on drive, at this point I only have a backward option, so I'll add that in and I'll press play and Dash moves backwards. So it says, good job. I think it is in this one. We can make it incorrect and you'll see what happens. So here it's saying that it wants it to move forward, backward and forward again. So I'll close the illustration and I have my when start block. And it said forward, backward and forward. So I'm going to do forward, forward and backward to show you what happens if you don't follow the instructions. I press play. And you can see that the incorrect block is highlighted in red. So then I can go back and I can change the code and make it forward, backward and forward, press play again. And once again, when it's successful and you've completed the task, you'll get confirmation. And we press good job and green arrow. So the tutorials under puzzle work exactly like that. And each one moves slowly more and more forward using more of the coding options down the left-hand side of the screen. But notice that it only highlights and allows you to use the code that it wants you to learn how to use. So it's introducing you slowly to each coding block as you work through the tutorials. Puzzles is something students can complete by themselves. They don't necessarily have to do this with a teacher, and they can do it at their own pace. So I'm going to, in the top left-hand corner, click on the blue arrow to return to the front screen. The other options we had was My Projects. If I click on My Projects, you can see that I don't have any here at the moment. But here's where we can download projects and we can share with other people. So I'm actually going to go back and I'm going to go to Create New. When I click the plus to Create New, here you can see that there are projects that have already been created that students can run and see how they work, or they could modify them to do something a little bit differently, or they can create a blank project, as you can see in the top left, that's in a circle. So I'm going to click on the blue and white blank project. And then I'm going to say create in the bottom right-hand corner. Now what we have, this is free play. So now we have the option of actually creating code and we have all of the code available to us in the rainbow of code options on the left-hand side. So we always have a when start button. If students happen to accidentally lose that, so there's a bin here, I can hover over it and it will actually get rid of it. So for example, if I go in, you can see, and I press on each of the colored code, we have different options. So here's driving, we've got forward, backwards, turn left, right, etc. Let's take a look at the forwards. If I add the coding block underneath and I actually click on the number 50, this opens the parameters of the block. In opening the parameters of the block, you can see that we can actually make dash go up to 100 centimeters in one movement, and down to 10 centimeters. We can also change the speed. So we have a bit of a speedometer here, and we can use that by either moving the arm of the speedometer, or we can use the plus and minus on the bottom of the speedometer. So if I click, you can see it's got simple language. It says that it's very slow, slow, normal, fast, and really fast. All of the blocks have parameters that you can click on and expand. For example, if I take a turn left, I drag it out and put it underneath forward. When I click on this turn left and I click on 90, you can actually see we have a little dial here, and part of that, this is great for working with angles and helping students to understand and consolidate maths concepts. So if I wanted to do a 180 and I pull it around the rest of the way, and you can see that the circle changes from green to yellow. And if I expand again and do 3/4 of a turn, I go to 270, and again that circle changes from yellow to green. We have more yellow now. And if I want to do a full 360, then the whole circle becomes yellow. We can move in smaller increments. So each increment, there's 15 and then 30, and so on around the circle. So this is great for students to learn about acute, obtuse, and so on. If I click on the arrow at the bottom, It takes me back to my page where I'm programming. If we look at the other blocks available to us, we have look. And we have look left, look up, and look towards voice. If I drag a look left on, and I click on the left, you can see that I can actually have the option of changing so that he looks right, or that he looks forward. Remembering that Dash has a motor in his head that allows him to pan up and down to make it appear as though he has a head movements like a person or a robot. So we can change that from left, forward to right and varying degrees. If we go to light and we look on that, we can add a block in that says make all lights one specific color. So I'll make them purple. We also have sound blocks where there are pre-recorded sounds, but like paths, you can also record your own sounds. And again, if you click on the number in My Sounds, you have 10 options to record your own voice recordings. So, and it works the same with path where we record a new sound, we pick a slot, we press the microphone, and at this point, a pop-up appears saying that Blocky would like access to the microphone, and we say okay. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
Okay, so I'm gonna tick that sound and place that. Now you can see the sound is saving into slot one. So, I now press on back to app. And you can see that one is highlighted, slot one is highlighted, and I can click on the arrow in the bottom of the pop-up, and you can see the block with My Sounds has a number one for slot one. There are also animations. If we look on the block animations, there are lots of things that Dash can do. If I drag out one of those blocks, and you can see dance Dash, and he can be confident, he can be silly, do a square dance, left, right, let's do confident. And Dash is already testing that block out. So we can also do things like drawing a square. So if I pull away some of this code, I'm gonna place it in the bin in the bottom right and let go. And if I take a control and I say repeat, I'm gonna add that repeat under the starting block with my move forward really fast, 10 centimeters, and then I'm gonna say turn left 90 degrees, and if I get him to do that four times, I can then get Dash to navigate a shape. You could actually have students work with perimeter in math with this, have them tape out the shapes on the ground, and then have them program Dash to navigate those shapes. So I'm going to press play, and then Dash will actually move forward 10 centimeters really fast and draw a square. Okay, and so there he is, and he's completing that square. Okay, so there are other things here. There are variables, and there are also accessories that you can buy and use with Dash to extend that a little bit further. For example, you have a launcher, a sketch kit where you can place a marker in there, but you can also, there are plans on the Wonder Workshops website where you can actually build your own marker holder and use the connectors that come in the kit to actually get Dash to draw things and use that same process for students to interact with Dash. And there's also Gripper Building Kit. So there are plans already on the Wonder Workshop website that you can check out and follow. Okay, so I have my when start repeat, and I'll change that to four times. And this is to create a square, moving forward and turning right four times. Now, before I share this, I'm only going to profile, which is the icon that looks like dot that's next to Dash in the top right hand corner. So it's the one with a purple background. And the top right hand corner, I'm going to click on that, and you can see it says select your profile. Currently, I have one profile there. I can use this profile and edit it if I'm a student and I want to come back to this later. And I put in Kath, I can personalize and save my progress under this profile. So I've got Kath, I can change the background color to blue and I can tick. So now if I click back on the profile, you'll see that it now is Kath's profile. Okay, so in the top left-hand corner to share the project, you can see next to the hamburger is a blue and white block. I'm going to click on that blue and white block, and it's already provided it with a project name called Lion and Mouse. I go to the white circle pop-up that looks like an alligator mouth in the top right, and it says Upload Project. I click on Upload Project, and I am given a code. The project key is GGAI, so I can write it down or remember it. I'm going to press the arrow at the bottom of the pop-up, GGAI, and I'm going to change the profile. I'm going to manage the profile. I'm going to create a new profile. I'm a new student now. I'm coming in and using this, and my name is Ryan, and I'm going to have a green background and tick. So Ryan's now using this. And when Ryan comes into the program, he wants to access, if I click on this profile and change to this one, you can see in the top right-hand corner that I have a green background around my profile, so I'm now in under a different name. And when I go to My Projects and Download, I enter the key, GGAI, and press Download. And I can now see the project that Kath created, which is the when start is pressed repeat 4 times, move forward and turn right. So I now have that program here, which I can run myself and test it. And perhaps I want to modify and save the project as well and share it with somebody else. I can change back to Kath and I can continue working on this. You can also use different iPads and use the same code to access this, as long as they're all connected to the internet or the Wi-Fi within the school. So we've looked at puzzles, we've looked at my projects, and we've created a new project. I hope you've enjoyed participating in the video today, and be sure to check out our other videos on how to use Path, how to use Wander, and how to use Swift Playgrounds.
This video is part of a series of support videos all about the kit that you have borrowed. To find the other videos in this series, head to the Learning Library and visit the kit page for the equipment you've borrowed. You can also find the full list of support videos for all of our kit on the YouTube channel. You can also join us in the Yammer community. If you have any questions or you'd like to ask teachers how they've used the equipment in their classroom, then why not join us on the STEM T4L Facebook community? It's a closed group. You can ask teachers how they've used the equipment and also share the work samples that your students have created.